إن الذين يتلون كتاب الله وأقاموا الصلاة وأنفقوا مما رزقناهم سرا وعلانية يرجون تجارة لن تبور ليوفيهم أجورهم ويزيدهم من فضله إنه غفور شكور.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most gracious, most merciful. And we send blessings and salutations upon Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless him, his entire household, and his companions. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless every single one of us. My brothers and sisters in Islam, we welcome you in this series, the introduction to Tajweed. And I welcome my guest here, Harun. How are you, Harun?
Alhamdulillah, I'm doing good.
Where are you from, Harun?
From Ghana.
MashaAllah. Welcome, my brother.
Thank you.
And Abdurrahman, how are you, Abdurrahman?
I'm doing good, Alhamdulillah.
Where are you from?
Coming from Ghana, too.
You're also from Ghana?
Yeah.
MashaAllah. Ahlan wa sahlan.
Thank you.
My brothers and sisters, we would like to mention the ayah in Quran, in Surah Al-Muzzammil, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا. Recite Quran aloud with a slow, pleasant tune and style. And you know that our Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him, said أيكم, to his companions, أيكم يحب أن يغدو إلى بطحان والعقيق فيأتي منهم بناقتين كوماوين في غير إثم ولا قطيعة رحم. Which of you would like to go every morning to بطحان and العقيق? You know, بطحان and العقيق are places near the Medina. Yani, it's like two neighborhoods. To bring two camels, two she camels, two large she camels, without being guilty of sin and severing the ties of kinship. All the Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, oh our Messenger, we all like to do that. He said, if you would go to the mosque every morning to recite two ayat, two verses from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from Quran, that is better than two large she camels. And to recite three ayat from Quran are better than bring three she camels. And four is better than four camels. And to own their number of camels. This is a very high level of the value of Quran, of worshiping of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we are trying to reach this point of the thawab, of the reward. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us.
Amen.
In the last episode, we mentioned the rule of ghunnah. And we said that when we find the noon, stressed noon and stressed meme, the noon has shadda, meem has shadda, we extend the nasal sound, which is the ghunna. The voice comes from the nose. Inna, thumma. And you know that the stress shadda, stress noon and meem is about noon sakina, consonant noon, plus noon has a short vowel, fatha or dhamma or kasra. Yani noon sakina plus noon mutaharrika gives you نون مشددة, which is the extend the nasal sound الغنة. That was the last episode. In this episode, inshallah, we will explain the rules of نون ساكنة. You know the نون and ميم are like sisters. They are participating in the same rule, which is the غنة when they are مشددة, has شدة. But when the نون ساكن has sukun, and when the noon, the meem has sukun, are separate. The noon will have about four rules, which is the أحكام النون الساكنة والتنوين, the rules of نون ساكنة and تنوين. And when the ميم has سكون, it will have about three rules, which is أحكام الميم الساكنة. Okay? Now, النون الساكنة has four rules. We can divide the Arabic alphabet into four groups. The first group has six letters. The second one has also six letters. And the third has one letter. And the fourth one has the rest of the Arabic alphabet, which are 15 letters. Now we will study the first one, the first group, which is Al-Izhar. When we have Nun Sakina or Tanween, you know that Nun Sakina, there is no vowel on top of it. There is no Fatha, no Kasra, no Dhamma. And Tanween is like Nun. When we add Nun Sakina in the noun, for example, if I say Yadhhab, Yadhhab is a verb or a noun?
It's a verb.
It's a verb. Yadhhab. We can't add tanween with the verb in Arabic language. But we add the noon, the tanween, which is the noon sakina, only in the noun. For example, I say Ahmad. We can say Ahmadun. Or Afwan, Muhammad. We can say Muhammadun. Because the Muhammad is a noun, we can add this tanween. So the tanween is actually a noon sakina. So it's the same rule, nun sakina or tanween. Okay? When the nun sakina, you know the articulation point of the nun is the top of the tongue with the upper gum. When this the tip of the tongue hit the upper gum, the nun exits. Okay? An, na. So there is a big distance between the nun sakina and huruf al-idhar, which is the first rule of ahkam al-nun al-sakina wal-tanween, al-idhar. You know, al-idhar is the clarity or showing, for example, or appearance. Appearance or showing or clarity, any word of this, this is the meaning of the idhar. Idhar, you let the nun appear. Appear the noon when it's followed by one of six letters, which are the throat letters: al-hamza wal-ha, al-ayn wal-ha, al-ghayn wal-kha. Six letters. These are the letters of the throat. So we said izhar halqi. Throat is al-halq in Arabic word. Al-halq is the throat. So when we say the throat, إظهار حلقي, which is the throat or the letters of the throat, six letters. When we find these six letters followed by the noon, we make the noon appearant. يعني we make an إظهار, حكم الإظهار. Okay, understand? Okay. But without increasing the غنة. For example, من عمل, we have نون ساكنة, من, followed by عين. العين is one of the إظهار letters. We make the نون مظهرة without increasing the غنة in the نون. We don't say من عمل. This is increasing, is not right. It's wrong. You just let the نون exit from its articulation point without غنة. But this غنة, inshallah, we'll explain in إظهار أو الإدغام بغنة in the next episode, inshallah ta'ala. Here we have some أمثلة, some examples. For example, they say rules of نون ساكنة and تنوين. نون ساكنة refers to any noun normally occurring in the middle or at the end of a word while carrying a sukun, which indicates the absence of a vowel. يعني sukun, there is no vowel, there is no haraka, يعني fatha or dhamma or kasra. Tanween indicates and identified article and a cause only at the end of a noun. We said we can't add the noon and the tanween in the verb. It's written as a second diacritical. يعني فتحتين ضمتين كسرتين. تو ضمة تو فتحة تو كسرة. It's written okay. Short vowel make identical to that accompanying the last letter of the word, but pronounced as a noon ساكنة. For example, basharun. We say here, we see on the screen bashar. We add the noon. It's like tanween. Tanween is like noon ساكنة. Basharan, basharin. Okay.
Okay.
طيب. Now we will see the examples of the izhar, of the clarity. I will recite the example and you repeat after me. منهم
منهم
إن خفتم
إن خفتم
كفوا أحد
كفوا أحد
واسع عليم
واسع عليم
من ألف شهر
من ألف شهر
وهم ينهون عنه وينأون عنه
وهم ينهون عنه وينأون عنه
سلام هي حتى
سلام هي حتى
أجر غير ممنون
أجر غير ممنون.
So in these examples, we find here منهم, this one is نون ساكنة followed by ها. And what are the letters of إظهار الشيخ هارون?
The letters. همزة.
أيوة.
ها. عين. حاء. خاء. غين.
أحسنت. أحسنت. Perfect. ما شاء الله. These letters, the six letters, we make the idhar when the noon followed by one of these of letters. Minhum, we find this noon followed by ha. So we make idhar in noon. In khiftum, ha Sheikh Abdul Rahman. This noon followed by kha. And what are the letters of idhar?
The letter of idhar there is kha.
Aywa.
Because it came after the noon.
Yeah. What are the letters?
Of izhar, hamzun, ha, ayn,
ha,
kha,
ha,
ha, iwa,
ghayn,
ghayn,
kha,
wa ha.
Ahsant, ahsant. Six letters. Okay, we need to memorize these letters because okay. When we find the examples in Quran, you directly make izhar in nun sakina followed by one of these six letters. Okay.
Okay.
طيب. Some examples I recite. تحتها الأنهار
تحتها الأنهار
من غسلين
من غسلين
من خير
من خير
مقام أمين
مقام أمين
من عمل
من عمل
رزقا حسنا
رزقاً حسناً.
This is the examples of تنوين. رزقاً حسناً. For example, here رزقاً. We see here تنوين فتحتين to فتحة followed by حاء. And this is إظهار.
Yes.
We as we mentioned before, we don't increase the غنة in إظهار. Okay.
Yes.
طيب إن شاء الله we will recite سورة الإخلاص. I will recite. You repeat after me. إن شاء الله تعالى.
Okay.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
قل هو الله أحد
قل هو الله أحد
الله الصمد
الله الصمد
لم يلد ولم يولد
لم يلد ولم يولد
ولم يكن له كفوا أحد
ولم يكن له كفوا أحد
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
قل أعوذ برب الفلق
قل أعوذ برب الفلق
من شر ما خلق
من شر ما خلق
ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب
ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب
ومن شر النفاثات في العقد
ومن شر النفاثات في العقد
ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد
ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد
بارك الله فيكم. I will let شيخ هارون recite سورة الإخلاص. تفضل.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد.
أحسنت. بيرفكت ما شاء الله. الشيخ عبد الرحمن.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد.
أحسنت. بيرفكت ما شاء الله. Do we have any إظهار in this سورة سورة الإخلاص؟ There is.
Yes.
Which one?
You say, وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٍ. There is تنوين
yes.
followed by همزة.
كُفُوًا أَحَدٍ. You're right. This one, تنوين, is followed by this همزة. This is an إظهار.
Yes.
أحسنت بارك الله فيك.
آمين.
وفتح الله عليك.
آمين.
جزاكم الله خير.
آمين.
Thank you, my brothers and sisters, for listening. إن شاء الله in the next episode. We will explain the idgham بإذن الله تعالى. جزاكم الله خيرا. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
إن الذين يتلون كتاب الله وأقاموا الصلاة وأنفقوا مما رزقناهم سرا وعلانية يرجون تجارة لن تبور ليوفيهم أجورهم ويزيدهم من فضله إنه غفور شكور.